So, Christchurch happened about a month. What? I mean, you quite literally asked for it. I mean, it's horrible what happened. Horrible thing. And one of the things that really surprised me, and surprised most people, especially the Muslim community, was that for the first time ever, or in memory, this attack was actually characterized as a terrorist attack. Which never happens when a white guy does terrorist stuff. When a Muslim does terrorism stuff, sure. But when a white guy does terrorist stuff, they're always like, oh no, that's just some sad, lonely, isolated loner. Oh, he's got nothing to do with the rest of us. He's just a lone wolf, you know. Maybe he had a bad childhood. Maybe he played some violent video games. Must have listened to some rap music. Definitely not Coldplay or Johnny Barnes. Must have been definitely rap music, black rap music. He's just a lone wolf. Oh, he's a lone wolf. Whereas if a Muslim does some terrorist stuff, even if they're freaking mental, they're like, oh, he's a terrorist mastermind, he's a terrorist. Why is the community silent? Well, the Muslim community clearly silently endorses him. He's their guy. He's handpicked by ISIS. He's a terrorist mastermind. Whereas the media's like, no, he's just alone. Just alone. Look at his blonde hair. Little blonde angel child grew up to be a lone wolf. Lone white people have a lot of lone wolves, whereas apparently our wolves have more of a team spirit. Our wolves have unionized. Like, even when our wolves are clearly freaking mentally ill, they always try to characterize he's a terrorist mastermind. Like, I don't know if you remember, the middle of the Lindt Cafe siege. Like, in the middle of that, like, the media were like, they were characterizing him as an ISIS mastermind, handpicked by the leadership. This guy, remember, in the middle of his siege, one of his hostages said to him, excuse me, that flag you've got is not actually the ISIS flag. He's, what do you mean? That is the ISIS flag. And they go, no, it's not. And they Google image and showed him the ISIS flag. And he goes, oh, what's that? Like, oh, I don't know, maybe it's like the Saudi Arabia flag or something. So then his primary demand of the police was to bring him the correct ISIS flag. What kind of a shit ISIS fangirl is that? Oh yeah, no, I love ISIS. I'm a massive fan of ISIS, you know. I've listened to all their albums. I'm a massive ISIS fan. What bullshit you have, mate? What's your favourite ISIS track? Oh, you know, all of them. I listen to all of them. Oh, I don't even remember in the middle of the Bourke Street attack in Melbourne. Like, I mean, Scott Morrison now, after Christchurch, he said all the right things, didn't he? He called that guy a white terrorist, you know, white right-wing extremist, white supremacist. He used all the right words. But back in the middle of that Bourke Street mall, straight after it happened, he said, this guy represents the biggest threat to Australian national security. He said, this guy, if the Muslim community don't condemn him hard enough, well, they're just going to have more of these guys producing society. And he basically connected the Muslim community to this guy, and then the media were all like, yes, he's a terrorist mastermind. The whole community is behind him. How did this terrorist mastermind do his terrorist mastermind? He drove his car into Bourke Street Mall, parked outside the Target, tried to blow it up by setting barrels of petrol alight in the back seat, didn't really catch on fire, then he ran around with a knife, like the terrorist mastermind he is. The first person he stabbed, a Muslim security guard. Now, I'm pretty sure that's an own goal. No, he's a terrorist mastermind of the community silent because they all secretly endorse him. He's their guy. What a freaking insult. All right, fine. If you accept that we're all terrorists, all Muslims are terrorists, you think that's our guy? He's our best and brightest. That guy, 1.6 billion Muslims, choose that freaking idiot. First, 9/11 in 2001. Then we give you the stabby mall guy. 1.6 billion of us chose that idiot. What, so he just rocks up to the meeting. ISIS, I'm here, I'm the guy. Everyone has chosen me. What do you want me to do? We want you to go to Bourke Street in Melbourne. Oh shit, that's like the World Trade Center in Australia. All right, yeah. All right, what's the target? Target. Oh shit, you got the Twin Towers in 2001, then you got a discount clothing and toy store, 2008, that'll strike fear into the heart of tight asses all across Australia. Alright, what do you want me to do? ISIS, you're the scariest terrorist organisation in the world, I'm handpicked. What do you want me to do? You want me to set a series of explosives under the road, time to detonate, with peak shock? No. Do you want me to maybe hijack a plane? Like fly it into a tram? No, we want you to just drive your Toyota into the mall. Sort of try to set some petrol alight in the back seat, then just get out, run around with a knife, man. Just woo! Woo! Just go crazy, have a good time, woo! Until the police crack the shits and shoot you, you know, it's a foolproof plan. No one will be able to stop you. Yeah, no one will be able to stop you. No one will be able to stop, unless of course you encounter a homeless white guy with a shopping trolley, but you know, what are the chances of that happening? You are a terrorist mastermind.